Okay, I just wanted to talk about this awesome flower. It's called the lupine. Phenomenal flower, and it has these very interesting leaves. I mean, this is basically dead, but the leaves open up and spread out like a fan. That's not a good example. I have a living one down in the orchard that I'll show you. And anyways, we were up camping with some friends at the BLM land on top of Black Ridge. And we saw all of these lupines sitting there, white ones, purple ones, blue ones. They were gorgeous and everywhere and very large. So I decided to dig some up and bring them here and plant them. And you might think, well, why would you want to do that? Because I want to increase the permaculture in my area. Here on top of the ridge, I have all these wood chips, which is good to increase, insulation for the roots, water absorption. It's really good for the soil underneath to be able to protect it from the sun. But the thing that I want to point out with these lupine, they were up at a high elevation in a desert area. There was grass that was surrounding it. Sorry about the dog. That is the neighbor's dog. Won't stop sometimes. But either way, I dug these out. And one of them that I dug out here, this is a white one. I looked at it and I was like, gosh, look at that root. That is one single taproot. That is really long. But that's not the end of it. So when I went and dug another one, I made a circular cut around the base of it, not getting to the center. And then watch this. If I follow, look at that. This is the taproot. Man, it is busy tonight. A lot of people out and about. But that's the taproot. That thing is 3 feet long for this little flower. Stellar. So I'm going to bury these in the ground. I don't know if I'll be able to dig that deep of a taproot. Maybe it'll live, maybe it'll die. I'm not sure, but it's getting pretty dry right now already. And so I need to get some moisture on it so that it'll live. But I'm going to plant these in the grass, or in the grass, in the wood chips. And I have these other wildflowers. I don't know what they are, but they're beautiful. Orange, they smell awesome. So I have white, blue, and violet lupine that I'll be planting up here to help with cross-pollination for my fruit trees. So I'll show you where they're planted after I plant them. All right, this is the blue lupine, or as somebody else calls it, this is the Russell Hybrids lupine. See on the tag? So different colors will come about from this. This guy does not look very healthy. I don't know why. It grows great out in regular nature, but here, not so much. Maybe I'm watering it too much, but leaves feel a little dry, so maybe I'm not watering enough. And these tend to have a taproot, as you just saw, so makes me think infrequent watering, but deep, because those roots go real deep. Here with the pawpaw, lupine. If these make it, it was a nice long drive bringing them down. Another lupine next to the persimmons. This nice little beautiful one right next to muscadine. Another lupine between the gumi bushes. Another wildflower. Beautiful, smells good, nice color. Another lupine next to another muscadine. And here's the biggest lupine. I just like saying that word, lupine. And honestly, I don't know if they'll make it, or maybe it'll go to seed and it'll grow next year. Either way, I thought I'd give it a try, see if I could plant them and have more life here on the hilltop. All right, I hope that that video was informative to you, especially if you want more flowers in your area of other fruiting trees and such. All right, either way, have a stellar day, and I hope you enjoyed the video. Bye.